Trigger warning: police, gun, and taser violence. People with disabilities who also identify with other underrepresented populations, such as through race, gender, or sexual orientation, are disproportionately affected by the criminal justice system and police brutality. This video will share the narratives of Jamichael Mitchell, Freddie Centeno, Bruce Kelly Jr., Caden Clark, and Natasha McKenna, who were each killed by police officers. These narratives will show what repeatedly happens to people with disabilities who are of color and in the LGBTQIA community. The disability community and members of the IL community need to understand intersectional advocacy and stand in solidarity with other social movements. Disability solidarity.
Jamichael Mitchell. Jamichael Mitchell was a 24-year-old black man that was diagnosed with schizophrenia and bipolar disorder. On August 19, 2015, Jamichael was found dead in a jail cell with the walls and floors covered in his feces and urine.
His cell was stripped. He had no cup, no spoon, no shower shoes, no socks, no underwear, no shirt, no blanket, no pillow, no sheet, nothing. He had nothing.
Dylan says jail staff took away the 24-year-old's basic privileges, what you might see as basic human rights.
In the 101 days he spent in jail, Jamichael lost 38 pounds due to his refusal to eat or take medication. His transfer to a mental health treatment center had been ordered twice by a judge, but no beds were available. Jamichael was being held on $3,000 bail, which his family could not pay. His crime was the alleged theft of a Mountain Dew, Snickers bar, and a zebra cake that totaled $5.05.
Disability solidarity.
Don't shoot! Don't shoot!
Freddie Centeno. On September 3rd, 2015, Fresno police officers responded to a 911 call.
911?
Yes, hi. I want to report a man that just came up to my door. He's walking around shirtless with a lot of tattoos, and he came up to my door and said he was a federal agent, and he pulled out a gun.
Hey, Fresno PD, get on the ground. Get on the ground!
3 seconds after arriving and exiting the vehicle, officers unload 10 shots, hitting Freddie Centeno 7 times and fatally wounding him. The police discovered that the object they believed to be a gun was in fact a garden hose nozzle. Freddie Centeno was a Latino male with a psychiatric disability. And reports have shown that people with mental health disabilities are 16 times more likely to be killed by police.
Disability solidarity.
The whole world is watching! The whole world is watching!
Bruce Kelly Jr. Bruce Kelly Jr. was a 37-year-old black man with schizophrenia. On January 30th, 2016, Bruce and his father, Bruce Kelly Sr., were approached by officers for drinking unspecified alcoholic beverages.
Police officers from 4 departments respond to this, surrounding Bruce Kelly Jr. very closely. The officer on the far right you can see has his gun drawn.
This led to Bruce Kelly Jr. walking away from the scene with a pocket knife in hand.
There are several attempts here to stop Bruce Kelly Jr. On the far left, you'll see an officer run into the screen, attempting to use his baton to hit Kelly in the arm, but he spins. They also tried to pepper spray him twice, but then you can see he jumps over the fence, and this is where he goes out of camera view. And now canine Aaron and his handler come into play.
After 20 minutes and efforts to subdue him with the use of a taser, one of the 10 officers following him released a canine. Kelly Jr. stabbed a dog after he was bitten. This resulted in police firing 12 shots.
When canine Aaron fell down, Zapala says his handler fired 10 shots and another officer fired twice, but we don't know yet how many times Kelly Jr. was hit.
Kelly Jr. was struck 7 times and killed. 4 days later, a procession of police cars traveled to downtown Pittsburgh where hundreds gathered in uniform for a memorial service to honor the canine. Bruce Kelly Sr. was not allowed to attend his son's funeral, but was released from jail weeks later.
Disability solidarity.
Caden Clark was a 24-year-old white transgender male who had multiple disabilities, including Asperger's, PTSD, and anxiety. This video shows the emotional support Caden received from his service dog during an episode in which he was inflicting self-harm. Clark also experienced many forms of depression due to doctors wanting to cure his Asperger's disease before he would be allowed the proper tools to fully transition.
I don't know where to turn to. If anybody in Arizona is listening to this, please guide me because I'm at my losing point. I'm going bonkers. Every single doctor, whether it's mental health, whether it's any kind of therapist, DBT, CBT, nobody seems to know what the fuck Asperger's is. And it's frustrating. They all want to make a treatment plan of how to cure my fucking autism. And it's so fucking frustrating. I wish I didn't have it. I wish it was a cure for all pill. I'm serious. I don't know what else to do. I'm frustrated. I can't do anything in my transition because I'm stuck in this stupid roadblock. Like, seriously, I'm at my wit's end with people. I've been to every single fucking doctor who takes my insurance. I've been to every doctor who's done the sliding scale, and at this point, I'm done. I really am, and I don't know what to do.
On February 4th, 2016, police showed up to Clark's home in response to multiple calls indicating he may be suicidal. The police report shows that Clark approached the officer with a knife, and the officers, feeling threatened, shot Clark. Clark's mother states, "Before the police arrived, he wasn't posing a threat to the community at all, and the police came into his own place. They shot and killed a 24-year-old autistic, mentally ill individual whom they had been familiar with and aware of his special needs. There has to be a better way for law enforcement to respond and handle situations."
Disability solidarity.
Natasha McKenna. Natasha McKenna was a 37-year-old black woman diagnosed with schizophrenia and bipolar disorder who died while in police custody. Natasha McKenna's disability was often described as mentally ill, deteriorating, combative, dangerous, and demonic.
Natasha, we're here to take you out.
On February 3rd, 2015, McKenna was scheduled to transfer from an adult detention center in Fairfax County to a center in Alexandria.
You promised that you wouldn't kill me. I didn't do anything.
Okay.
Please, have a kneel down.
Kneel down.
Ma'am, if you don't kneel down, ma'am, kneel down. Kneel down on the ground.
I've got one leg.
On your knees.
The transportation team, which consisted of four sheriffs and two supervisors, forcefully restrained McKenna's naked body with handcuffs and leg shackles. She was tased multiple times before she stopped breathing.
Yeah, before we move on, everybody good? Good.
First, can you take him out? Can you
give
him
a blanket?
Yeah. I'll take him out. Somebody have gloves for Mason?
Henry, go suit up. You're going with them.
The autopsy report shows McKenna's cause of death was excited delirium, and the police deemed her death an accident. Excited delirium is a condition that is not recognized by the American Medical Association.
Disability solidarity. The disability community cannot be just an ally in this struggle. We must seek liberation for all of us, and not the freedom of some. We must stand in solidarity by uplifting the voices of marginalized groups within our own community. We must also see how our silence and inaction contributes to the inhumane treatment of people of color, deaf people, and LGBTQIA people in the criminal justice system. How can disability organizations and agencies engage the criminal justice system to prevent the violence and reduce the incarceration rates our community faces, and operate through an intersectional framework that is inclusive to other marginalized groups? This video is a product of NCIL's Diversity Committee, with support from the Women's Caucus, Queer Caucus, and Youth Caucus. We would also like to thank BYP 100 DC Chapter for their guidance on this video.